PA. It's News on the Way. Good morning. I'm Kayla H.
And I'm Ben V, reporting from the remote Rosemary Angelina Broadcast Center.
Today is Tuesday, February 1st, 2022. It's day 9 of the 12-day cycle.
Our Pledge of True Allegiance will be led by some of our students. Please stand, face the flag in your classroom, and put your right hand over your heart to recite the pledge.
Please remain standing for a moment of silence.
Please join us in reciting the Bobcat Pledge, led by Mrs. Miley's first grade class.
We pledge to be ready, respectful, and responsible.
Please be seated for some news and announcements. Today, the big story in the lane is that it's Groundhog Day is coming up tomorrow, Wednesday, February 22nd. Each year, Punxsutawney Phil, everyone's favorite groundhog, comes out of his hole to predict if there will be 6 more weeks of winter or an early spring.
Before then, we'd like to hear your predictions. You can make your prediction before February 2nd. Just go to the News on the Lane feature stories link on the website to select your prediction. We will share the results of our survey and Phil's prediction on Wednesday.
We have some birthdays to announce this week. Take a look.
Happy birthday, everyone.
Today's main lunch is grilled cheese, tomato soup, steamed green beans, bean carrots, and your choice of juice or fruit.
The alternative lunch choices are a PB&J, sandwich, or other assorted deli sandwiches.
Pitch Club meets today after school.
Board Game Club teams B and C meets tomorrow after school.
There is a staff meeting tomorrow morning at 8 a.m. It is time for Tuesday Trivia. Today's question is, how often does February have 29 days?
The choices are A, every other year, B, every 4 years, C, every 10 years, or D, every year.
And the answer is
B, every 4 years.
February 29th occurs every 4 years and is known as a weekday. All the other years, February has only 28 days.
Today's the first day of Chinese New Year celebration. It's the most important annual holiday celebration in China. We are going to share the top 10 fun facts that all kids should know about Chinese New Year.
Number 10. In China, the New Year holiday is called Spring Festival because it marks the end of the coolest part of the winter when they begin to look forward to the spring.
Number 9. Chinese New Year is a festival celebrated by a quarter of the world's population. That means that it isn't only celebrated by China. Over 2 billion people around the world celebrate Chinese New Year in some way.
Number 8. Billions of red envelopes called leafies are exchanged each year during the festival seasons. Giving a red envelope is a way to send good wishes and luck as well as money. People also give oranges and tangerines to one another as gifts.
Number 7. The Chinese New Year date changes every year, and it always falls between January 21st and February 20th, and it's determined by the lunar calendar. That's why some people call it the Lunar New Year.
Number 6. Every Chinese New Year starts a new animal zodiac year. 2022 is the year of the tiger. The tiger is considered the king of all animals in Chinese mythology and culture. It symbolizes power, courage, confidence, leadership, and strength.
Number 5. The Chinese New Year Festival is celebrated for 16 days and ends with the Lantern Festival. On the night of the Chinese Lantern Festival, the streets are decorated with colorful lanterns. People eat sweet rice balls, watch dragon and lion dances, and watch fireworks.
Number 4. Sweeping, washing, and taking out the garbage are not allowed on the first day of Chinese New Year because it is seen as washing away one's fortune at the beginning of the new year. That includes taking a bath.
Number 3. Red decorations are everywhere during the Chinese New Year celebrations. Red is a lucky color in China. It represents many positive things such as beauty, happiness, luck, health, success, and good fortune.
Number 2. Kids love the Chinese New Year holiday. They get a month off of school, new clothes to wear, and receive red envelopes with money in them. They also get fun activities, spend time with family and friends, and also see fireworks.
And the number 1 fact about Chinese New Year is, there is the biggest world firework usage during the Chinese New Year. The loud bangs and flashes of light are believed to scare off any evil in the New Year. Local governments set up the firework displays.
Today, Mrs. Barton's first grade class will have a special Zoom presentation by Declan's mom about Fat Tuesday.
Here are some more of the second graders' haiku poems.
Winter, making a snowman, throwing snowballs at my brother, playing in the snow by Thea.
Winter, I love snow days when I love to drink hot chocolate. I love ice skating by Allie.
Winter, light. Building snowmen, like making a snow angel, having a snow fight by Anderson.
Winter, I love hot chocolate. I build snowmen in the snow. Love winter so much by Michael.
Go. Winter. I love snowboarding. I like sledding and snow days. I love hot chocolate by Nicholas.
Winter. I like to go sled. I like to watch snow falling. I like to throw snow by Casey.
Winter. I like hot cocoa. I love snow day. It is fun. Catching snowflakes on my tongue by Georgia.
Snowy winter. I love winter fun. I love to make snowman. So fun. Snow is so fun. Yay! By Grayer.
Winter. For these snowflakes fall. When snowball snowman so much fun. Winter is snow much fun.
Wear coats and gloves, hot chocolate in my PJs. I love the snow so much by Cora.
Thanks for sharing these with us, second graders. Thanks to every class that has been returning library books each morning. Miss Townsend places the return bin just outside the library door until about 9:20 each day. If you do not see the bin, bring the books into the library. Thanks so much for all your help with this. And now, here's Peyton N. with today's special report. Peyton, what do you have for us today?
Thanks, Kayla. Today's special report is about Groundhog Day. Groundhog Day is on February 2nd, when the groundhog comes out of its hole at the end of hibernation. Groundhog Day is a popular North American tradition observed in the United States and Canada. If he sees his shadow, he predicts 6 more weeks of winter. If he does not see a shadow, he predicts an early spring. I know I'm hoping for early spring. What about you? Back to you, Ben.
Thanks, Peyton, for that special report.
For all crew members and special reporters, I'm Kayla H.
And I'm Ben V. Have a totally terrific Tuesday.